Well, thank you very much, and thanks for choosing to interview me and find out more about me. My name is Lawrence Anirejo Orisia-Wilbert. I tend to define myself or describe myself as a child of various events, being, you know, the people I meet, the places I've lived, and my experiences in all this. So I would say I'm a child of Bendel State, groomed in the Midwest, or rather in the middle belt of Nigeria. Okay, world experience in Europe, America, and Nigeria. You know, effectively, right now I'm the chief executive officer of Agilent Wireless Limited. It's a sister company to Genie NJ Communications. Agilent Wireless Limited is a mobile value-added services aggregator and content producer. What does that mean in a nutshell? Because many people would not know. The simple way to put it is we provide information, jokes, content over text messages and voice, that's IVR, through the mobile network operators. Effectively, that's what we do. We are a company of staff strength, approximately 50, with half that team of the staff focused on content development and for the Nigerian space and Congo, DRC, and the Cameroons. Well, I wouldn't say it's by chance, but I think it's a consequence of the various work experiences which I've built. I did my first postgrad degree in the former Soviet Union, specifically in the city of Odessa in the Ukraine, in the Odessa Polytechnic University, where I studied, I finished with a master's degree in electromechanical engineering. Subsequent to that, I did a postgrad degree in telecommunications and computer networks from the South Bank University in the United Kingdom. Post that, I got my first job in the city of London as a technical support engineer in the financial space. I spent some time doing that, becoming a project manager, delivering real-time data systems to the investor houses and the stockbrokers. There was always something in me that wanted to come back to Nigeria to share my experience, but more importantly, I had this innate belief that Nigeria, Africa, was a place to be. Like I typically say, where there is so much bad, permit me to say, good now becomes a hot commodity. So where you have so much of chaos or disorganization, once you can put things straight, then you are hot. You'll be highly sought after. With that in mind, I thought, okay, Nigeria is a place to come, share my experience, learn new things, learn how things are done here, and see what I can contribute to the development of Nigeria. Hence, I came back to Nigeria, but I didn't come back into telecommunications. I got the opportunity to be the executive director of in charge of operations for a oil and gas servicing company, which provided, well, maritime service, platform supply vessels to the oil majors. This was in the year 2001. And also doing pipeline integrity. It's quite interesting. We're having pipeline bust right now. Pipeline integrity management and stuff like that. That's what that company called Polmaz focused on. I spent 2 years with them, and I had to now say, what can I do with my own skills in telecommunications and do for myself to see if I can venture to set up a vehicle to deal with my aspirations. Hence, in 2003, together with my colleague Peter Idovia, we got to set up Genie NJ and got it going. And it's been an interesting ride so far. When it comes to the mobile vast space. That came as a consequence of our experience with the mobile telcos. We thought we had the solution. We had the technology via our technical partners. We had the contacts. It simply made sense for us to go into that space. More so, it's a space where Nigerians can more easily get into. We can develop the content ourselves and own it easily, instead of utilizing foreign technology. So we thought, let's grow that space, create employment for people, and effectively, you know, be big players in it. And I dare say, today we are within the top three in the mobile value-added services space, and we do provide good service. Okay, let me have, it's quite an interesting question. I would address it this way. Nigeria, with a population of over 160, some say 180 million, it's a huge market. Nigeria, with a population of over 160 million, has a huge reservoir of human resource that can explore and exploit any sector of knowledge, of enterprise in the world. When you consider countries as little as the islands you have in the Caribbean, and you find them producing top athletes, you know, in various spaces. Look, for example, the 100 meters champion. They are cricket champions. Only recently, they won the Cricket World Cup. You find other small countries becoming number one or number two in various spaces. Now, transpose that to Nigeria. Many of these countries are not even as big as Lagos. It means if they can be number one or top three in whichever space they choose to focus on, Nigeria can be number one or top three in any and every space we choose to focus on. That is one. Two, with a population size of over 160 million, we as Nigerians have a lot of needs because we are a people, we are human beings. We have to eat, we have to relax, you know, recreation. Would like to be as good as any other group of people anywhere in the world. And I dare say, permit me to say, we are amongst the best anywhere in the world when you consider the Nigerian entrepreneurial spirit. So with that in mind, I thought coming to Nigeria, it's a natural aspiration because it simply made business sense, not even just considering the fact that this is home to me. I'm a farmer boy. I grew up in Benin. My dad was an agriculturist who, at the end of his post his career in the civil service, where he was a permanent secretary, he set up a plantation of oil palm, pineapples in the Odogwu Forest Reserve. That is beauty in nature. From that simplicity, you find that there's a lot in Nigeria that we can explore. Coming into Nigeria, I find that whichever skills and knowledge I've acquired abroad, I could utilize it in creating various things here in Nigeria to my own benefit and to the benefit of others. And I'm grateful to God for the opportunity that in this company right now, with a staff strength of approximately 50, I can confidently say that we feed at least 10 family homes. You know, if there is nothing else I've done in my life, for me, that is beautiful justification for being alive today. As a matter of fact, just to add on to In answer to your particular question, now I've spoken about where Nigeria is coming from. Now, in this present day, with the administration of Muhammadu Buhari in place, we are going through tough times. We have been a mono-product economy, depending on our oil reserves. Now, that is not available for us to play around with anymore. And I dare say, permit me, it's a blessing to Nigeria. Because now that we do not have the freedom to depend on that product for our sustainability, we can then look inwards and look into other aspects of our economy, which we can then explore. I would want to emphasize the following. What is needed right now is to unleash the entrepreneurial spirit of the Nigerian man, because there are no better group of entrepreneurs anywhere in the world but in Nigeria. Let's look at various sectors that are waiting to be developed. Look at the maritime sector. The maritime sector alone in Nigeria can feed Nigeria. It can employ Nigerians. Look at what is going on with countries like Philippines, which produce 60% of the labor force for the maritime sector worldwide. Nigeria can take that place. That is one. Natural minerals, mines. What have we done about that? It's still yet to be explored commercially. Agriculture, like I just told you, I'm a child of an agriculturist. There is huge potential in that space. We need to rightly explore that. So when we talk about the Nigerian economy, it's going through tough times right now. As a business, we are feeling the impact. However, I have hope. I have hope because we are Nigerians. I have hope in the Nigerian man's spirit. I have hope because not just in the spirit, we have what we can explore to make us who we be. Great people, and we are good. I want to reflect on something which many of us do not think most of the while. We have a great nation called Japan. We all know Japan for their electronics. We all know Japan for, if you meet the Japanese as a group, you see how prim and proper they are. They're organized. But do you know that in Japan, they do not have what we have, oil. They hardly have natural minerals resource like we have here in Nigeria. Sadly, what they do have is all sorts of natural disasters. Now, juxtapose that, and then you now start asking yourself, how does such a small nation compare to Nigeria, with all the problems with nature, have economy size that it's arguably second or third, if we say the first, fifth, top economies in the world, Japan. Then what about Nigeria, where we don't have those natural disasters? We have the huge plethora of mineral resources. We have the huge resource of human beings, entrepreneurs. We are meant to be number one in the world. That's who we be. We just need to get our policies right as a nation. We just need to be focused right as a nation. And that is what now, 2015, is giving us the opportunity for. Going through these tough times, we have our backs to the wall. It's now time for us to unleash what we have as a people, because we do have it. Now we just need to think about it and bring it out. So I have great hope for the future of Nigeria. If not now, I actually do feel that's why I returned back to Nigeria in the year 2000. I feel privileged to be a contributor to the Nigeria economy in different facets. One, I'm an employer of labor, of which it's a huge privilege for me. Two, I'm the chairman of my local community in Ikoba Oka local government area in Edo State. It's a Shekiri community called Ikara. I'm the executive chairman of that community. So I'm working with my exco, with my team, with a plan to convert that little village into a town within a 10-year period. Thirdly, I also contribute to Nigeria through my alumni association, Federal Government College Ugolawo, and by extension, the Unity Schools Old Students Association. I was, just for the record, I was 4 years the national president of the Old Students Association of Federal Government College Ugolawo, and I was 2 years prior to that, Lagos chapter president of the Old Students Association. This in itself, if I may talk about it a bit, gave me the opportunity to, again, give back to my school, but more importantly, build a platform where my fellow old students who I might have grown up with for 5 years of my, from 11 to the age of 16, and others who went through similar experience, can network, empower themselves in their career, empower themselves financially, and in business, help them network with other stakeholders in the Nigerian space. So yes, I do. I think I can tap my hand on my chest and say, yes, I'm a good contributor to the Nigerian economic space. Wow. Unity Schools Old Students Association, USOSA. Let me talk about that briefly before I answer your question. It's a platform umbrella body which has a consisting membership of all Unity Schools in Nigeria. 104 Unity Schools. That is a massive umbrella body. And when you consider that the Unity Schools, the Federal Government College, set up with a motto of pro unitate, is meant to provide educational platform, first rate educational platform for Nigerians or any other person that chooses to be educated in Nigeria. One, it's a school education vehicle for the promotion of unity of Nigeria. And, you know, thirdly, with all that, build in certain values of the Nigerian person, integrity, creativity, and of course, like I said, a focus and love for your fellow Nigerian. Now, with that in mind, you'll find that this umbrella body, USOSA, it's a huge vehicle for national integration and national development. I dare say it's the biggest alumni association in Africa, if not the world, you know. And with that in mind, I think I feel privileged to be considered to vie for the position of President General of USOSA. It's a shadow, not even a shadow, it's a quarter of a shadow of what it should be. It's meant to be a platform for bringing together all the Unity Schools, also the alumni from all the Unity Schools, again, to re-energize those virtues which we were taught in our 5 years as children. It's meant to be a vehicle, an advocacy vehicle for intervention in government policies, in education, and by extension, development in Nigeria. Okay? There are a lot of issues in Nigeria. Nigeria needs USOSA. My aspiration within the 2 years of the tenureship is to build USOSA into a veritable vehicle for its representation. The representation of USOSA, by that I mean, you know, the coming together of all the Unity Schools, because right now not all associations are active members of USOSA. I dare say not all USOSAns, not all old students of Unity School even know about USOSA. So I'll be working to create visibility for USOSA and its mandates. With that, of course, once we have created that, it gives us the opportunity to integrate better, network amongst ourselves as Nigerians. I emphasize, when I say integrate better, if you think about it, where citizens from the north, the south, the east, the west, the north is the northwest, the south is the southwest, all under one umbrella body, common training, come together as true Nigerians, what we will be doing is transferring the identity of the Ishekiri man, the Hausa man, the Yoruba, the Igbo, the Kanuri, the Ibibio, the Margi. We'll be transferring all of them from that to the Nigerian man, the Nigerian person, where we'll feel equally as comfortable in our home in Ikara as we'll be in our home in Sokoto or even Maiduguri. My aspirations are those. Build the structures in USOSA to create for it to be able to empower the various alumni associations, create visibility for USOSA, so we have everyone and anyone that is a USOSAN to feel part of the USOSA family. And with that, we'll then have a veritable vehicle for educational advocacy intervention to be able to build Nigeria better through building the unity schools to be what they are supposed to be. Yes, USOSA is an umbrella body for all 104 unity schools. Okay, when I say unity schools, I need to explain here. Federal government colleges in Nigeria, which includes King's College, Queen's College, and the Suleja Academy in Abuja. USOSA being an umbrella body, of course, the consisting members of USOSA are the alumni associations from all these 104 unity schools. The associations are considered the members of USOSA, not the individual, but the associations. And once you have your association as a member, the individual has become part of it by default. Yes, we have the next plenary coming up on the 23rd of April 2016 in Abuja. And it's in that plenary, there is going to be the main agenda for the day. It's the election of the National Exco. My aspiration is born out of my innate desire to be a positive change for good in whichever environment I find myself. My singular question which I ask myself is, why did God create or permit for me to be born here in Nigeria? Because many people, you might see me and get confused. Some people have been told I'm Indian. I've been told, someone even said I'm Chinese. I've been told I look like a South American, or I'm even a European. But no, in all that, I am Nigerian, and proudly so. Now, being in Nigeria, it means I am meant to create positive change here in Nigeria. Now, with that in mind, I now look to leaders, forerunners, people who have created positive change. You now talk about people like Nelson Mandela. There is no better example of someone to aspire to be like in leadership, in creative positive change, in society. I wish I could be a quarter of what he has done or he has been. I would just like to state that we are who we are as Nigerians. We are good people. We are a great nation. Like it or like it, we are. What is now important for us as a people is to look deep into ourselves and see what God has put into us and bring that out for positive change. We are privileged right now to have a leader, a president like President Muhammadu Buhari, who is altruistic in all his ways, who just wants to see positive change in Nigeria, who wants to nurture the good, what, the bad and the ugly into creating that positive environment in Nigeria for us to now be who we be. We all as a nation, as a people, need to tap into that right now. Because albeit that it is tough, it's going to get better. I would want to live amongst people who have that positive aspiration. I would want to, each and every one of us, to challenge ourselves to bring the best out. Because even at that, that is where I get the best out of myself too. You know, create that positive environment for the right competition. Above all, I want to say to everyone, please, there is a God. Believe in God and listen to what He's telling you by the day.